It is very important that landlords know how to track costs by apartment. There are many reasons to track costs by apartment. Apartments with more expenses could indicate a hidden physical danger. Apartments with more expenses could indicate a problem tenant. Apartments with fewer expenses could indicate a neglectful tenant. And cost for a particular apartment could be compared to the revenue, the income, of that particular apartment to make business decisions, such as how much to charge tenants for that apartment. It's very easy to write checks or enter bills when paying money or getting bills from vendors regarding the running of your apartments. You can review the related videos included in this course video playlist. And even if you don't review the videos that are included in other courses that show how easy it is to record writing checks or entering bills, it really is common sense and very intuitive. The job costing feature is what allows you to separate the expenses by apartment. For example, let's imagine on January 20, Holden paid $350 to Joe the plumber for a plumbing job in apartment 3A, and he wrote check number 61. It's very easy to record this transaction. We have the check icon in the icon bar. We make sure that we choose that we're paying from the correct bank account. And of course, this is 2017, so this will be January 20 of 2017. And we paid Joe the plumber, $350. And of course, we're not going to print the check later, so we're going to remove the check mark print later from the main tab, so we can type in check number 61, which is a handwritten check. Now, everything seems easy, but the only thing you have to be careful about is the bottom of the window. Move the mouse to the bottom left and click once under the word account. That'll bring the pull-down arrow, and when you click the pull-down arrow, you get a list of every account in your chart of accounts. And you will choose the type of expense that fits the category for this particular check. In this case, this is your plumbing expense. The only extra step you have to do for job costing is to click the pull-down arrow and choose which particular tenant or which particular apartment this plumbing expense was for. We're not going to bill the tenant for it, so you can remove the billable check mark by clicking on it. When we click Save and Close and we look at Profit and Loss by Apartment, we can click the icon bar and see that this is really the profit and loss by job report, and you can watch the supplemental videos on how to modify the report to change the title. But if you look at just 3A, Dave the Tenant, this is how much income you've earned from Dave the Tenant so far, because the date range here is automatically set to all. But of course, you lost money from Dave the Tenant because you had plumbing expense that lowered the amount that you made, because you had to pay $350 in plumbing expense to be able to earn that $3,000 in rental income. So you can see the true profit for this particular apartment. Let's try another. Let's imagine on February 20, Holden paid Staples $200 for supplies needed in apartment 4B with check number 62. Well, that's no problem at all. Click the check icon from the icon bar. QuickBooks remembers the check number that you left off on, so you just confirm that it's the right number for the handwritten check. Put the date that you actually paid. Put the money amount that you paid. You put the vendor whom you paid. In this case, it's Staples. And again, the reason for this check is supplies expense. Now, the extra step requires that not only do you put supplies expense, but you tell QuickBooks which particular tenant and which particular apartment these supplies are for. QuickBooks will automatically put the check mark for billable as if you were going to bill this tenant for it. In that case, you could leave it there, but you can remove it and then save and close. Now, when we look at the profit and loss by apartment, you can see for apartment 4B, Donna the tenant, you can see now has, even though you earn $2,400 of income, you have $200 of supplies expense that relate to Donna the tenant, and now your profit for Donna is only $2,200. Our last example is very important. Imagine on March 20, Holden paid Rex Repair for fixing the wall between apartment 4B and apartment 5C. The $1,000 check that we wrote to them should have their cost split between the two apartments. Let's take a look at how we would record that. Well, of course, we're going to open the Write a Checks window. It's check number 63. The date is March 20. And I guess Rex Repair is the company whom we paid the $1,000 to. Now, notice it puts the whole $1,000 down here in one particular row at the bottom of the window. What we need to do is split this $1,000 for $500, which would go to apartment 4B, and the other $500, because QuickBooks knows there's 500 remaining, will go to apartment 5C. And in both of those cases, it would be repair expense. So it's repair expense for apartment 4B and it's repair expense for apartment 5C. We're not going to bill them for it, but there's a very important rule that you have to remember. The total on the top of the window must be equal to the costs on the bottom of the window. That means when you add up each row's amount at the bottom of the window, it has to total the amount on the top of the window. And in this case, the $1,000 check does equal $500 in repair expense for 4B plus $500 in repair expense for 5C. When we click Save and Close and look at the profit and loss by apartment, you can see that 4B has a lot of expenses now. They had supplies expense and repair expense, bringing your profit of apartment 4B down from $2,400, which is what you collected from them, down to $1,700, which is actually what you made from them, because you had to pay these expenses. Notice Johnny in 5C only has that one expense, $500. In closing, I'd like to leave you with a very important piece of advice. If you have a lot of repairs for one particular apartment, you can use the Attach Documents feature to collect proof of a problem tenant. So what does that mean? Well, for example, Donna in 4B has accumulated way more repair than any of the other tenants in the other apartments. Of course, a moment ago I shut the video and recorded some extra repair expense for Donna just to illustrate this point. So imagine you're looking at the profit and loss by job, which is really the profit and loss by apartment in your case, and you can see one particular tenant has one particular expense way more than the others. Now, in order to see each individual check for that particular tenant for that particular expense, you can double-click on the total, and QuickBooks will give you a list of each individual check that added up to Donna's total for repair expense. If you want to attach the actual receipt that you got from the repair shop for the check that you wrote, then all you have to do is scan the receipt in as a picture to your desktop. Then you can double-click the particular check that goes with that receipt. In this case, for example, the check on March 25th, check number 64. If we double-click, you can see everything you put in the window when you recorded that check. You can change any piece of information you want about this transaction and save it, and the information in your QuickBooks records will be updated for the change. But the most important point is here. In the ribbon in the main tab, there's a command called Attach File. You can click Attach File, then click Computer. Then you can search your desktop for the repair receipt that you scanned in as a picture. So this picture is a file that is actually the receipt given by the repair shop for the check that we just opened. We click open, and now that receipt is attached to that check in QuickBooks. And now we click done. Then we can click save and close. So in the future, if you have to go to court, you can print this profit and loss by job and maybe change the name of it to profit and loss by apartment and show the judge the repair expense of all the other tenants compared to the repair expense for Donna. You can double click the total and print every repair expense check for Donna. And then you can double click the check itself and you can take a look at the attached file and print that out as the receipt for proof. Thank you for taking our Landlord QuickBooks course.